A newbie's guide to an ultralight engine. These engines tend to be two strokes, as four strokes are heavier, thus harder to make the ultralight legal. You're looking at the most popular engine and prop setup for ultralight aircraft. Quicksilver has sold 13,000 aircraft with this setup. This is a very popular Rotax 500 and 352 horsepower engine. While no longer manufactured, engine parts, service, and rebuilt engines are plentiful. Hi, I'm Courtney. Thanks for stopping by. Most two-stroke engines are pull start. In some applications, electric start is available, although difficult to make legal ultralight weight. We have the air filter here. Dual carbs, although smaller engines have just one. Dual ignition system for redundancy. Vacuum fuel pump, works real well. Take a moment to bloop the like button below. Drive shaft coupler. On some applications, gear drives are available, and they're great options. This is a belt drive system. A two-stroke aviation engine specific muffler. This is a ground adjustable prop. Exhaust pipe and manifold here. Dual exhaust temperature ETG probes. Dual ignition, dual spark plugs per cylinder. A true aviation specific motor. Dual grounding switches, one for each ignition system. Two pumps of the choke usually gets a pull start running. Half the time first pull works. Get on the Patreon team to help bring this channel to you. Idle on these engines should be at 2000 RPM. Full static RPM limit should be 6300 RPMs. Overheating is what kills two-stroke engines. Regular maintenance, fresh gas, and monitoring engine gauges is what keep these engines alive. Grounding the engine is what stops the motor.
I'll see you in the skies. Bye.